Hello everyone, I am Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. DPC or damp proof course is a very important topic for building construction and other construction as well. DPC or damp proof course is a layer of waterproof material in the wall of building near ground to prevent rising damp. In older houses, slate were installed as DPC, but in modern house it will be plastic. There are other materials as well. In summary, DPC is a layer of a mixture of concrete and a waterproofing agent which is applied on the plinth beam before the walls are built. DPC acts as barrier through the structure designed to prevent water rising by the capillary action. Such phenomenon is known as rising damp. Now let's discuss about where to apply DPC. Generally applied at the basement level of ground and plinth, which restricts the movement of moisture through the wall and floors. You can check your current DPC by taking a look at your external walls. If you see a thin black line about 6 inch up from the ground, that's your DPC. If you already have a DPC but are seeing signs of damp or black mold in your building, it is needed to be replaced. DPC should always be out of reach of water that can splash from the ground. DPC layer is generally laid below masonry wall. Why should we apply DPC? To prevent damp issues from occurring and to stop any existing problems. To prevent water seepage. If the existing DPC becomes breached by debris or vegetation, it's needed to be replaced. To avoid the effect of efflorescence. To protect the basement from termites. To protect wall from white patches. To avoid the damage of electrical fittings. Water can seep into house from the ground. This can cause dampness in your home. DPC is an effective way to stop this from happening. Provision of DPC prevents entry of moisture in the building. What is damp? Dampness is the presence of hygroscopic or gravitational moisture. Now let's discuss about effects of damp. It gives unhygienic conditions apart from reduction in strength of structural components. Dampness gives rise to breeding of mosquitoes and create unhealthy conditions. It causes softening and crumbling of plaster. Wall decoration or paint is damaged. Dampness results in disintegration of brick, stones, and tiles. Flooring gets loosened when moisture enters through the floor. Timber fittings such as doors, windows, almira, etc. coming in contact with damp, walls, floors get deteriorated. Electrical fittings get deteriorated, giving rise to leakage of electricity and danger of short circuits. Floor coverings are damaged. Dampness promotes and accelerates growth of termites. Dampness breeds germs of diseases like tuberculosis, neuralgia, rheumatism. Moisture causes rusting and corrosion of metal fittings. Now let's discuss about causes of damp. Wall structures are founded on soils. If the soil is pervious, moisture constantly travels through it. Even in the impervious soil, lots of soil moisture may be present. The moisture rises up into wall and floor through capillary action. Groundwater rise also results in moisture entry into building through walls. If the wall tops are not properly protected from rain penetration, rain will enter the wall and will travel down. Leaking roofs will also permit water to enter. Heavy shower of rain may beat against the external faces of walls. And if the walls are not properly treated, moisture will enter the wall, causing dampness in the interior. If the balconies and chaja projections do not have proper slope, water will accumulate on these and will enter the walls through their junctions. Moisture will completely damage interior panes of walls. Due to condensation of atmospheric moisture, water is deposited on walls, floors, and ceilings. Now let's have a look for types of damp. There are three types of damp. The first one is rising damp. Rising damp occurs when water from the ground begins to travel up through brickwork and will be noticeable by tide marks on the inside and or outside the property. Penetrating damp, it is also known as lateral damp, is the development of the moisture through the walls and roofs or below ground area of a property. Condensation, probably the most known and common form of damp is condensation. The built of moisture in your home from cooking, having showers or bath, or simply breathing can get trapped and cause condensation and mold. It will mostly be visible on windows, and mold growth can occur in areas where there is limited airflow, such as behind furniture. Buildings should remain dry or free from moisture traveling through walls, roofs, and floors. If you are noticing signs of damp or black mold in your property, the best thing is to do is call a professional damp proofing company to arrange an inspection. They will confirm if you have a damp issue that requires a DPC. Okay everyone, this is all for today, and this is all about DPC. I hope this video will be helpful for you to understand this type of damp problem in your house. If you have further more questions about this video or any other questions on civil engineering, then please comment below, or you may use the email address that I have given to description. Till then, happy learning, keep practicing. See you in the next video.